listening to the Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Glenn Hall Taylor's black episode, Circus Life, Carnival of Menace. Starring Ross Martin. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company and Lazy Boy Recliners. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
Circus is a mammoth variety show performed in a huge auditorium such as a giant sports palace or a convention hall. Only the little circus is still performed under canvas in the manner tradition once decreed. Such a circus is the Lang and Haley Show and Carnival, which is winding up an engagement in a small Indiana town. It is Saturday night, shortly after dark, as the dancing girls of the sideshow prance onto the platform for a final teaser. Before the crowd files into the main tent, a crowd unaware of the tawdry life behind the brightly spangled, exciting world they're about to enter.
Rusty, before you go out there to give your spiel, I got a tip for you.
Yeah, what's that?
Just that you're asking for trouble hanging around that Carol dame in the money wagon, the one they call Princess.
Oh, are you jealous, Dolly?
She's Turk's girl, you know.
Look, Dolly, I just kid around with all the girls, you know that.
Okay. But Turk's gonna catch you guessing her weight one of these days, and he's
Turk's a friend, baby. I ain't trying to cut in on him. Come on. And start tickling the keys on that Calliope Getter crowd.
Okay, sugar. Just tipping you off, that's all.
Under the big top. Now then, before I tell you all about the sensational attractions inside, I want these beautiful little ladies with their silver baubles and their bouncing personalities to put on a little dance for you. A dance that'll put a bowl full of jelly to shame. Hey, you with the bald head.
Hey, Rusty, come here, will you?
Yeah, hiya, Turk. Yeah, I haven't seen you around all day. What's up?
I only got a minute. Tonight's the night. Now listen, we'll be pulling out of the railroad yard after midnight, about 1 o'clock.
Yeah?
All right, as soon as the train's underway, you get the poker game started. Make sure the security man is in it.
That flatfoot hasn't missed a game since we hit the road with the show.
Stay about even in the game yourself so nobody squawks. Then pull out about 2:30.
Okay.
All right, I'll be waiting for you out on the platform, and we'll make it up to the flat car where the money wagon is. There'll be more than 20 grand in the safe tonight.
Hey, that's a lot of bread.
Yeah, like a whole loaf. Now then, you stay away from me until we meet on the platform. You got it?
Gotcha. See you tonight. Hey, hiya, Princess. How's the most devastating creature in the world? Lonesome, I hope.
Oh, brother, are you a cornball?
Turk says tonight's the night, honey.
Well, don't broadcast it. What do you want?
Well, you know, I got to thinking 2/3 of 20 grand is nearly 14,000 clams. You and me could take it and have a real swing in time on it.
You and me?
Uh-huh.
Huh. Get this, Rusty. Once and for all, I like it the way it is with Turk and me, and it's going to stay this way.
Listen, I got what Turk hasn't got, baby. Brains. All he's got is muscle. How far are you going to get on that?
Why don't you ask him? Here he comes now.
Oh, Princess.
Or do you want me to ask him?
Hey, Rusty, what's up?
Well, I just dropped over to check the time we meet tonight.
Well, I told you, 2:30.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Well, see you later.
Okay.
Turk?
Yeah?
There's something I gotta tell you. You may think Rusty's a pal of yours, but do you think it's safe having him on this job?
I gotta have help. Why?
Well, he makes his living talking. I'm just afraid he might let something slip.
Nah, don't worry none about him talking. He wouldn't cut his own throat.
Turk.
Yeah?
Be careful tonight. Please.
Don't worry, sweetheart. I'll be careful.
Raise it, Bob.
Beat me, Rocky.
Hey, come on. Don't everybody fool. I gotta get even. What's a possible 3-5s do, Sherlock?
Rusty, if that eight hits you in the middle and straightens you, boy.
You're a cop, Sherlock. You can always pinch us for gambling, you know.
If he doesn't start winning, he's liable to.
Or running my own dash.
Oh, yeah.
5 up, huh? Okay, I'll see you.
Well, the 8 did it, boys. Oh, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
You are one lucky stiff.
Oh, well, I'm a little short of even, but I gotta get me some shut-eye.
You? Sleepy?
Yeah, it's 2:30. I'm a working man, Sherlock. You get to sleep on a job.
Get out of here.
Good night, all.
Good night,
boy.
Well, what's the situation, Rusty?
Sherlock's loser in the game. He'll stick to get even.
Okay. Now, we'll be hitting that long, steep grade on the other side of the Wabash River any minute now. The train will slow down almost to a walk. And when she does, I'll get off on this side, you drop off on the other. That way, we can see the coast is clear on both sides, right?
Right.
Okay. And we run alongside the train and climb on the flat car with the money wagon. As soon as the train gets over the hump and picks up speed, we get to work. You got it?
Got it. You got the tools?
Right here.
We ought to finish the job just before we get to that deep ravine, remember?
Yeah, what about it?
We toss the tools in the ravine. Nobody will ever find them. We've hit the grade. She's slowing down.
Okay, that's slow enough. Here, jump off your side. We'll meet at the money wagon. Okay, she's starting to highball. Here, hold this chisel against the wagon lock.
Right. Okay, Turk, hit it. Again. That got us.
All right, inside the wagon, quick.
Now work fast now. I'll hold the flash. You take the hammer and knock off the knob, then I'll take the center punch and do the spindle and the sockets.
Right.
To get out of that wagon.
Some haul, huh? We got better than 20 grand in this sack.
Hey, how's that for timing? Look, the ravine's right up ahead here.
Okay. Hey, get ready to throw the tools into it.
Okay. All set, Rusty. Hey, you got the hammer, ain't you?
Yep.
Right here.
So long. Chump.
What happened to Turk?
I guess he just split with his share of the loot, took his dough and jumped off the train.
But why?
That ain't hard to figure, Princess. He's a wrong guy, that's all. I tried to tell you.
I set up the whole deal for him.
Well, that kind of shows where his gratitude is, doesn't it?
Well, he won't get very far. His running away has put the cops on him.
Remember what I told you about muscles and brains, sweetheart?
Yeah, I remember.
Look, I still got half to take, Princess. It's a little over 10 G's. I'm cutting it down the middle with you, 50-50.
What's the catch?
No catch. Just that we spend the dough together, that's all. Come on, how about it, sweetheart?
Sure. Why not?
Atta baby.
No, don't, Rusty. Not here.
Okay, Princess.
Now, we better figure on cutting out of this county real fast.
What about the law? After all, I've been keeping the books, and I wouldn't want anyone to suspect me in this deal.
Relax, baby. Turk's the only one they're looking for. We're clean. Get your things together, we'll be out of here tonight.
Oh, Dolly.
Yeah?
It's me, Sherlock.
Oh, hi, Copper. Open the flap and come on in.
Hope you don't mind my calling on you in the dressing tent, but I did want to ask you a couple of things.
Like what?
Well, you've been kind of friendly with Rusty Macon, haven't you?
Ben is the right word. Oh, brother. Him and his grabby hands and roving eyes.
Like that, huh?
Why did he mind so much when he was roving and grabbing around me? But he played the field with it, and I kind of like to be exclusive.
Hmm. Was he trying to move in on Turk's girl, the princess?
The way Rusty puts it, he kidded around with all the girls. I think he had a thing about the princess.
Could be. I did see him hanging around her now and then.
You working on this case, Sherlock?
Well, unofficially. You see, I was on the force before I got, hitting the bottle. But since I've been a plainclothes security guy with the circus here, even though I haven't had a drop in nearly 5 years, all they think I'm good for is bouncing drunks and kicking kids in the pants when they try to sneak under the tent. But I got a hunch about this robbery thing.
Oh, who do you suspect?
Rusty was a pal of Turk's, wasn't he?
He acted like he was. Mm-hmm. Except for the way he'd ogled a princess. Why'd he ask about Rusty? That makes three questions you've tossed me about him.
Well, it seems like more than a coincidence that Rusty left our poker game at about 2:30, wasn't it, that morning? Saying he was sleepy. The watchman said his berth was still unmade at 3:15.
That doesn't prove anything, does it?
No, but I also know that between 2:30 and 3:15, the train was on this side of the Wabash rolling toward Alney here in Illinois.
Well, what does that mean?
I don't know, but the robbery could have happened around that time. And that means Rusty just might have suckered me into staying in that poker game after he'd said he was going to go Betty by. Well, Dolly, thanks for that with me. Hope I didn't take up too much of your time.
No trouble, Sherlock. What are you going to do next?
I think I'll talk the section gang foreman into loaning me a crew and a motor car. I'd like to take a good look along that stretch of track. On both sides of it.
Back, baby?
Sure, Rusty.
Good. I got a car parked up in the street. Who's that?
Well, how should I know? Who is it?
It's me, Rusty. It's Sherlock.
Be right with you. Shut that suitcase under the bed. Hurry up.
Yeah.
Hi, Rusty.
Hi, Sherlock.
How you doing, Princess?
Okay, Sherlock, how are you?
Oh, fine, thanks. Sorry I have to bring you bad news.
Bad news?
Yeah. About Turk.
What about Turk?
Well, they found his body this morning in the ravine just east of Alney.
Oh, no.
You sure?
Mm-hmm. Identification was positive. Well, I guess that's all for now. Just thought you two want to know, especially you, Princess. I know you and Turk was friends, kind of. Well, close.
Yeah, thanks for dropping by, Sherlock.
Yeah, thanks. So long.
Did you do it?
Do what, Sugar?
You did. You killed Turk.
Are you the special agent in charge in this area? Good. The reason I'm calling the FBI is that I've got a felony case here involving the crossing of state lines. Indiana and Illinois. I'm the security officer with the Lang and Haley shows, the circus and carny outfit. Named Sheridan Lockman. On the way here, the show's money wagon safe was robbed of some $20,000. Yeah, there's a homicide involved, too. Well, the sheriff here's on top of the homicide, but you guys will want to move in on the robbery. I'm in the little town of Flora in Clay County. Okay, fine. I'll meet you at the money wagon on the circus lot. Don't lose any time. I think the suspects may make a run for it.
Okay, get in the car, Princess.
I told you I'm not going.
And I say you were. Now look, you're up to your level here in this and you know it. You set it up. And I'm not going to leave you here where they can put the squeeze on you and make you spill your guts.
Now get in there. Slide over and let me in behind the wheel. Yeah, that's better.
Oh, what's that guy think he's doing? He's nosed into the curb right in front of us.
Hey, you! Hey, pull up a little, will you?
Oh, the heck with that jerk. I'll back up and get up.
What's the matter?
There's another car right behind us.
You going somewhere, Rusty?
Hey, what's it to you, Flatfoot?
To me? Well, it's part of my job. You're under arrest for robbery and murder.
Oh, now what's that? A shot in the dark?
It's a carom shot, Rusty. From me to get the boss's money back, to the FBI for crossing a state line while committing a felony, and to the local fuzz for homicide. And all of us are here. Go on, look around. See for yourself.
Homicide? You're out of your good. Who is it I'm supposed to waste it?
Your pal, Turk. And you can cut the innocent act, Rusty. Your prints are all over them can-opening tools you chucked in the ravine. And the blood on the hammer matches up with Turk's.
Hey, now look, Sherlock,
My name is Sheridan Lockman to you.
Sheridan Lockman? Sherlock. Oh, that's why they called you Sherlock. You really are a detective.
You got it right, boy.
What was it you were saying about having brains, Rusty?
You don't have to rub it in, Princess. I gotta admit, I didn't claim I was the only guy with brains.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes, exercise your imagination, and join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Carnival of Menace was adapted for radio by Glenn Hall Taylor. Ross Martin was heard as Rusty. Featured in the cast were Jane Webb, Charlie Dugdale, Johnny Hamer, and Diana Hale. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Colas, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley D. Hoffman, Rochelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.